Hey, what's going on, subscribers? Welcome back to another brand new video from the Fleeing Prophets YouTube channel. I apologize if I sound a little bit sick. It's because I am, but I thought this video was so important that I needed to share with all of you as soon as possible. And what this is it is a parable that will make you realize how much money is enough and the true meaning behind happiness and financial success. It really makes you think. So I hope that you guys enjoy this parable that I'm going to share with you. And the parable is a simple story used to illustrate a moral or spiritual lesson. So that's what I'm going to be sharing with you, but it has to do with money. And it really amazed me when I read it. It's probably the best thing I've ever read because it really made me realize a few things. So yeah. And I do have some referral links in the description of free stock with Robinhood. That's the best brokerage that I know of. You can use that link in the description and you'll get a free stock as soon as you sign up. Then we do have M1 Finance, a really cool app that allows you to buy a fractional shares. So even if you just have $10, you can invest that in any stock that you want. And you also get $10 for your investments as soon as you sign up. And then with the Acorns, you get $5 as soon as you sign up. This links to your debit or credit card and it runs up your change to an investment portfolio. That way, you don't even have to think about investing. It kind of does it in the background. So let's go ahead and get started with the story. So this is the parable of the Mexican fisherman and the banker. So an American investment banker was taking a much needed vacation in a small coastal Mexican village when a small boat with just one fisherman docked. The boat had several large fresh fish in it. The investment banker was impressed by the quality of the fish and asked the Mexican how long it took him to catch them. The Mexican replied, "Only a little while." The banker then asked why he didn't stay out longer and catch more fish. The Mexican fisherman replied he had enough to support his family's immediate needs. The American then asked, "But what do you do with the rest of your time?" The Mexican fisherman replied, "I sleep late, fish a little, play with my children, take siesta with my wife, stroll into the village each evening where I sip wine and play guitar with my amigos. I have a full and busy life, señor." The investment banker scoffed. "I am an Ivy League MBA and I could help you. You could spend more time fishing and with the proceeds buy a bigger boat, and with the proceeds from the bigger boat, you could buy several boats until eventually you would have a whole fleet of fishing boats. Instead of selling your catch to the middleman, you could sell directly to the processor, eventually opening up your own cannery. You could control the product, processing, and even the distribution." Then he added, "Of course, you would need to leave the small coastal fishing village and move to Mexico City, where you would run your growing enterprise." The Mexican fisherman asked, "But señor, how long will this all take?" To which the American replied, 15 to 20 years. "But what then?" asked the Mexican. The American laughed and said, "That's the best part. When the time is right, you will announce an IPO and sell your company's stock to the public and become very rich. You could make millions." "Millions, señor? Then what?" To which the investment banker replied, "Then you would retire. You could move to a small coastal fishing village where you would sleep late, fish a little, play with your kids, take siesta with your wife, stroll to the village in the evenings where you could sip wine and play guitar with your amigos." So this kind of shocked me when I finished reading it, because basically he was already living his dream. He didn't need to make millions to be happy. He was insanely happy with just what his life was. Doing more would just cause stress to his life, affect what he values, which is his family, his children, his wife, and his friends. So by him doing the extra effort to do something that's unnecessary, he's already in the spot that he wants to be in the future. And he makes his living. He's very happy with what he does. He's not struggling financially every single day. He's content with his life. Someone like that should stay like that, because by producing a business where he has to spend so much time and dedication and leave his family and his passions just to get the same result that he's already enjoying, it doesn't make sense. That is why this story shocked me a lot and made me realize that you really have to think about what happiness is to you. Sometimes we as people who are very focused on financials and investing, we tend to think that happiness comes from money. But this isn't the case all the time. You could be very wrong, and it's better to realize it now than later on, where you spend so much time and energy on something that not even fulfills your life. And you might end up where you already are at the moment. So I'm not saying don't work hard or anything like that, or produce a business or anything like that. I'm still going to, but at least I know what happiness means to me. And you need to define what happiness means to you. Because once you have that clearly defined, you'll be able to actually achieve, be happy through the moments, and actually be happy once you get to your destination. Because you might be thinking that you need to succeed, you need to make money, and that's going to be what drives you to be happy. But you might be entirely wrong. That's why you need to spend a lot of time analyzing what it means to be happy to you, what is financial freedom to you. Because sometimes doing the extra mile, doing the best of the best, trying to be the top, might not be happiness to you. So just wanted to share this story. I hope that this story brought a different viewpoint to you, made you realize some things, and kind of wake you up. Because it really matters that you spend the time analyzing what you want out of life and what exactly do you want or want to do to be fulfilled, happy in all the areas in your life. And this is definitely achievable, but you need to plan out on exactly what you want. And I hope that this story brought you that message. So yeah, thank you all so much for joining me in today's video. I hope that I added value to your day and made you realize a few things. And make sure you subscribe to the Flaming Profits YouTube channel. We've been growing a lot. I really appreciate it. It's been a lot of effort, but I'm sure it's worth it. I love teaching people how to take care of their finances, how to invest in the stock market, and be a more profitable investor. I'm in one of the best investments right now, and I'm going to let you guys know how it's going. I have $10,000 invested right now into one stock. I'll let you know how it goes. So yeah, thank you all so much for joining me in today's video. Please make sure you like the video, subscribe so that you do not miss any brand new videos from this YouTube channel, the Flaming Profits YouTube channel. So yeah, like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you all so much, and I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.